I'm James McKenty.
And I'm Kelly McKenty. Several years ago, we thought, what if we built a recording studio in an Airstream?
And what if we put a vinyl record cutting machine in it? Today, we're headed to a show, but that's not where the journey began.
We found a 1973 Airstream Argosy, and it was in great shape. We had it retrofitted into a recording studio on wheels.
We wanted to travel and have the ability to record anywhere, anytime. We soon started planning events in a modern barn just outside of our town, and we invited our musician friends to come out and play.
At each show, we would record, film, and make a custom vinyl record.
And it was all done in record time.
So years ago, then a man went to sea. He said, Mary, I love you so. Oh, please, please wait for me. So she waited for 10 long years for a man to come home.
We're so happy to have Devin Cuddy come and play. He's just one of those old souls, and it's really recognizable in his music. When James showed me the album that he had recorded for Devin, Kitchen Knife. I could immediately hear Devin's connection to that kind of New Orleans jazz sound. And it seems fitting that during that time period in music, a young Wally Byam was beginning his journey in designing Airstream trailers.
Wally Byam started his first travel trailer out of his own design in 1929. He started with a Model T chassis and built on it a teardrop-shaped structure with sleeping space, a stove, and an ice chest. He even published a DIY guide so others could build their own, but the demand grew so high, he opened his own factory and started Airstream. They became an institution. They embodied the sense of spirit and soul of travel and adventure. In the 1970s, the company made a line of painted Airstreams they called the Argosy. Our Argosy is from the first year that they were released, 1973. They had the exact same build quality and structure of the silver Airstreams, but they were painted. We were excited to find ours in such great shape. We gutted it and had plans drawn up by our good friend Jim from Imagineers. Jim also did all the retrofitting, while another friend, Terry, did the bodywork, chrome, and paint. It's fantastic to look back on the journey and have it here today recording one of our favorite artists, Devin Cuddy.
This one's called Radio.
When I was young, when my eyes shone bright, couldn't wait to get beneath those lights. So I sat still, waited for so long, but the lure of fame, how it burned so strong. But now I don't wanna be on the radio. No, I don't. lied to my heart. Oh, and all it lacked. Well, I took this piano, how it sang right back. Well, and I went out into the world. Sang for the money, but mostly sang for the girls. Now I don't wanna be on the radio. No, I don't wanna be on the radio no more. No, and I don't wanna be on the radio. No, I don't wanna be on the radio no more. See the people sitting row on row. I just wanna be in the arms of someone I know. I sit in rags, from the top I fell. Somewhere along the lines it all just went to hell. And I've gone so far, now I'm coming home. Oh, tell my friends that I can't be alone now, and I don't wanna be on the radio.
Devin Cuddy. Fantastic.
Oh, he was great.
Yeah, he was so good tonight.
Couldn't wait to get beneath those lights. So I sat still, waited for so long. But the love, fame, my heart, it burned so strong. But now I don't want to be on the radio. No, I don't want to be on the radio no more. No, and I don't want to be on the radio. No, I don't want to be on the radio no more. So I took my heart, oh, and all it lacked. Well, I took this piano, how it sang right back. Well, and I went out into the world. Sang for the money, but mostly sang for the girls. Now I don't wanna be